Not only did she astonish the crowd and the judges, a YouTube clip of her
audition for the show has become a worldwide hit. At the age of 15, multi-talented singer and musician Justin Bieber is already an internet superstar.
As soon as she did that, she kind of anointed you, and all of a sudden, 10 million hits already.
Christina, and I'm 22.
I'm Catherine, I'm 20.
I'm Lisa, I'm 19.
I'm Amy, I'm 17.
I'm Lauren, I'm 14.
And I'm Danny, and I'm 12.
And we're Cimorelli.
Together, together, together. When we fly together.
Wow, that's awesome.
That was actually a good take.
Yeah, we did put up a video. Yeah, in 2007, we put up a video on YouTube. And it was like a Delaney music video, and it was like all of us. And it didn't get like any views, because I had no idea how.
It got like 400 views from Lisa clicking it.
Yeah.
Over all of it, but yeah.
It didn't get very many views, so we put that up. And then we just kept trying to build a following just like by playing shows. And then 2009, then Catherine was like, oh, we should put up Miley Cyrus Party in the USA. And I was like, I don't know, it sounds a little scary, like YouTube, it sounds a little bit scary. But we put up the cover of that August 2009, and then that blew up.
YouTube is the largest video sharing platform in history. It contains more content than anything else ever has in history. It's watched by more people than any other medium in history. And it is the greatest vehicle for watching video that we've ever known.
YouTube is on demand. We have the ability to access content at any time from anywhere and any device. Karmin was just named number one artist by the fans in 2012, on the cover of Rolling Stone. She's been Saturday Night Live and many, many others. Amy and Nick is the group Karmin, and they really got their start on YouTube. And like a lot of artists, they started by really just producing a cover.
Every time I come at you, gotta set it, then I gotta go, and then I gotta get it, then I gotta blow, and then I gotta shatter any little thing that you could think it'd be doing, because it doesn't matter, because I'm gonna murder everything and anything about a boom, about a bing, I gotta do a lot of things and make it clear to a couple of chickens that I'm always winning, and I gotta get it again and again and again. See, I've been waiting all day for you to come.
My relationship with Karmin started really as more of as a friendship in college, and I graduated before they did. I got my feet wet in the industry, and we kept in touch, and I tried to help them out as a band or as musicians as much as possible. And as Raw Sessions sort of, you know, became more and more successful, and we ended up breaking a couple artists online, you know, Amy and Nick reached out and said, you know, is there a way that we can potentially collaborate and work together? And I asked them to partake in this Raw Session, John Lennon 70th anniversary, sort of YouTube All-Star cast and this tribute project. And I ended up getting them a couple thousand subscribers that way, and, you know, worked out. And that sort of kickstarted our working relationship. And we decided to work together in development. And I proposed the idea of using what Raw Session did, meaning like the cover song strategy to break an artist, to build a subscriber base on YouTube and really build a fan base across all social networks. And they were really game for it. They really liked the idea and wanted to try it out. And so we really started out the relationship with me just suggesting cover songs on a weekly basis, right? I would look at the charts, and I would ask them to do two cover songs and one original initially each week. Which is a pretty tight schedule, considering that they were actually both a working full-time job.
Excuse my charisma, vodka with the spritzer, swagger down pat, call me out Patricia, Young Money Militia, and I am the commissioner. You don't want to start wheezy, because the F is for finisher. So misunderstood, but what's a world without enigma? Two chickens at the same time, synchronized swimmer.
was. Got the man twisted, cause he open when you twist him. Never met the guy, but I treat him like I missed him. Life is the witch, and death is a sister. Sleep is the cousin, what an awkward family picture. Older, life is colder than before. So you say, oh, 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 oh.
We definitely find time to like pursue other hobbies outside of music. Like we all have different interests that aren't just music, but it's definitely our number one focus. So we put a lot of time into it on a daily basis, but like on the weekends and whenever we get free time, we like, I don't know, go to the grocery store and get ice cream and like go to the movies and watch Twilight. Just random stuff like that.
So, and when we're together, we're like, since it's all of our sisters, we're still like being kids and interacting with each other like we normally do. It's not like work all the time. Even when we're working, it's still like a lot of our work at this point is like chilling in our room, talking about what we want to work on and stuff while we're in our pajamas. So
yeah.
I personally think just looking at social networks in general, I think video or the visual, even if it's a picture, let's say on Instagram, is probably more and more important, or is more important than audio or just a text post or something like that. If you look at high engagement posts, for example, on Facebook, or in general across other socials, where you get the most amount of engagement, reaction, or sort of viral activity, it usually is based off of picture posts or in general visual posts. So it's something that I think people find more more intriguing and, you know, I guess and more worth sharing than just a text post.
Literally, almost out of our attack.
We put up a cover of Windows Down by Big Time Rush. We're all huge Big Time Rush fans. Like, what, a week ago? And Kendall just tweeted our video. And he's my favorite, so it's a little exciting. I love all of them. All of them.
She does not want to marry him.
No, I don't want to marry him.
Dying dead.
OMG.
Cimorelli really went for it in this cover of Windows Down.
You no longer have to buy a single. If I'm in the mood to hear anything as old as Frank Sinatra or anything as new as whatever is out this week, right? And I like that song, you know, I might go to YouTube to watch it because not only will I have the song, but I'll probably have a music video to go along with it.
I know a lot of artists who get like noticed on YouTube, and they kind of like leave it behind as they get signed and stuff. But I think that's a really bad plan because you're like building this whole thing. And then if you leave it even just for a couple months, they can like forget about you basically. And then you try to go back with something and you don't have the momentum anymore.
Even as we like progress and get bigger and stuff, I think it's a mistake that a lot of people who are on the radio, like the biggest pop acts, don't upload things on their YouTube even once a month or once every other week. Yeah. Just a little blurb or like a vlog or a random video of where you're going, like fun YouTube updates. Some people do that in the beginning and then they just totally ditch and they only put like random Vivo things up. They don't keep their YouTube channel.
Like, I mean, people are on YouTube like all day. So why would you leave this place where everyone is?
Yeah.
I understand.
Like you can keep yourself relevant more and keep people interested and keep them up to date with your YouTube. I think it's really bad that people abandon that.
Yeah, and helps get your personality out there more,
yeah,
too. Because
videos are like the most important.
It's very important to continue to be transparent with your audience and keep updating them about what you've been up to, what's going on in your life, and you know, and not to sort of become Hollywood, right? And to sort of start being more selective with the kind of content that you're feeding your fans.
That authenticity is the main thing. People want to know that if you're a musician, that you're feeling the music, that it's something that moves you, that you're not just doing it as a day job or just to make money with it, right? That you as a musician are having fun with it.